Sumitra Goenka, the BJP agreed to Nitish Kumar's proposal that he should return. That is the way it should be looked at. But the question certainly is that the BJP is not leaving anything to chance, understanding fully well that post 22nd, it is on a high. There is that Hindu nationalism which is at play here. But they also understand that somebody like Nitish Kumar is a political necessity in the politics of Bihar.
Yeah, Maria, good afternoon. I think the main agenda of BJP has been development, and the development of Bihar now will be back on track with BJP coming together with Nitish Kumar. And this alliance is going to affect not just these 40 seats of Bihar for the Lok Sabha election, but I think another 40 seats across India will also get affected in a positive way. Like, it will have an impact on Bengal elections. It will have impact on other states like Jharkhand, probably even Delhi will have an impact, because we know that a lot of Bihar Biharis stay in Delhi, Purvanchali stay in Delhi. So it is going to impact not just Bihar, but it's going to have a lot of impact if BJP wants to go on the target of 400 plus in this coming election. And Nitish Kumar was one of the chief architects of the Indy Alliance. And his coming out, because you remember he had the first meeting also for the Indy Alliance in Patna. He initiated the entire thing. And after that, somehow in the last 2-3 months, we are seeing how things are just crumbling out of the Indy Alliance. There is no agenda. There is no uniformity in what they want. They are just fighting amongst each other. And one thing which is very clear is the partners in the Indy Alliance have also been, calling names to Biharis. So I remember DMK leader had said that Biharis are only here to clean toilets. Secondly, they also said that Sanatan Dharm is a dengue, malaria and all those things. So these things are going to affect, because see, when you look at the sentiments of the people, it is badly affected when somebody makes a direct attack on such sentiments. Mm-hmm. And that is something which is going to have a huge impact on the Indy Alliance. And somewhere I was feeling that Mr. Nitish Kumar was getting, he was suffocating in this alliance, because neither they were projecting him to be a leader, nor they were making him a convener in this, he was able to get the people together and form an alliance against the BJP. So it was a very tricky situation. And I believe he has taken a decision in the interest of the society, in the interest of development of Bihar. And this
is a good step ahead. But what does it do to his legacy, Sumitra? The question is that for 8 times, Nitish Kumar may be becoming the chief minister, but he will have lot to explain in terms of how, with complete smooth transition, he is having from one way to another. It's from the left to the right. Extremely, and he somehow manages to convince both the sides that he will be good for their politics.
I think
that is some art of politicking in Nitish Kumar way.
That is definitely, Maria, I think that is one thing which is the most predictable thing about Nitish Kumar, that he is the most unpredictable guy in politics today. And I don't know whether I should say that this is a best quality or this is not the best side of Nitish Kumar. But then in politics, when somebody is talking about the overall development, and we see how things change. And this is not something which was not expected, I would say. We were seeing some signs earlier also. And especially the Indy Alliance not coming together, and he was suffocating in that alliance. And I think this is something which then he had to take
okay,
a call.
Okay, Sumitra, just hold on to your thoughts. Let's begin with all the reactions that have come in. What is Nitish Kumar's reason for walking out of India? Let's listen in to the Chief Minister soon after he resigned.
आप सब लोगों को हम बता देते हैं कि आज हमने इस्तीफा दे दिया, समझ गए ना? आज हमने मुख्यमंत्री से इस्तीफा दे दिया, और जो सरकार थी उसको भी समाप्त करने का हमने आज गवर्नर साहब को दे दिया।
ऐसी नौबत क्यों आई?
अरे इसलिए नौबत हुई है कि ठीक नहीं चल रहा था तो इसीलिए थोड़ी परेशान। आप लोग तो हमसे बहुत पूछ रहे थे, हम बीच में बंद कर दिए थे कुछ बोलना, तो हम देख रहे थे तो वही सब लोगों की राय, अपने पार्टी के लोगों की राय, चारों तरफ से राय आ रही थी तो हमने सब लोगों की बात को सुन लिया, तो इसीलिए आज हमने इस्तीफा दे दिया। अब ये जो भी सरकार थी वो समाप्त कर दिया गया।
महागठबंधन को आपको छोड़ना पड़ा?
नहीं, हाँ अभी हम जो पहले गठबंधन को छोड़ के नए गठबंधन बनाए थे, और जो नया गठबंधन डेढ़ महीना से बनाए थे, डेढ़ साल से, तो यहाँ पर भी जो स्थिति इधर आकर के ठीक नहीं लगी है, और जिस तरह से लोगों का दावा हो रहा था, जो इतना मेहनत किया जाता था कि वही लोग कर रहे हैं, वो सब जरा धीरे धीरे लोगों को खराब लग रहा था, तो इसीलिए आज हम लोगों ने दे दिया, अलग हो गए। अब आज अन्य पार्टियां एक साथ होकर के जो पहले थी वो अगर आज ही अगर तय करेगी तो आज उसके बारे में फैसला होगा, तो आप जानिएगा, अभी वेट करिए। मैंने जो कर दिया, भाई हमने बता दिया कि हमको लगा, हम बीच में तो कुछ नहीं बोल रहे थे, आप याद करिए ना कि बीच में बहुत कुछ कहना चाह रहे थे, नहीं कुछ बोल रहे थे, हम कुछ नहीं बोल रहे थे, चारों तरफ की बात थी, कितना काम हम कर रहे थे, और उधर भी लोग हम अलायंस करवाए, क्या क्या करवाने में लगे, और कोई कुछ काम ही नहीं कर रहे थे, तो सबको लेकर के तकलीफ, और यहाँ पर भी लोगों को तकलीफ, तो ये हो गया तो हमने बोलना छोड़ दिया था। अब सबके लिए अभी आपको आज जो कुछ होगा तभी आप लोग रहिएगा, अभी रहिएगा, बाकी लोग आ जाएंगे और उसमें क्या लोग कहते हैं तो सबका बात सुन लीजिएगा, और उसके बाद जो कुछ भी होगा तो भी जान लीजिएगा। हमने छोड़ दिया,
जाने दो, हम लड़ते रहे, पहले आप और हम मिलकर लड़ते रहे, हम लड़ेंगे। लालू जी से जब बात किया, तेजस्वी से जब बात किया था, उन्होंने बोल रहे थे कि हमको भी ऐसा संशय आ रहा है कि ये हमारे हाथ से चले जाएगा, तो इसीलिए हम और आप मिलकर लड़ना है, लड़ेंगे। मैं फिर भी कोशिश करता हूँ उनको अपने साथ रखने का, अगर वो रहना चाहते हैं तो ठीक है, अगर हम कितना कहे तो भी अगर वो जाना चाहते हैं तो वो जाएगा ही, इसीलिए ये पहले से मालूम था, लेकिन हमने ये इंडिया अलायंस को इंटैक्ट रखने के लिए हम होके कोई बात अगर गलत करेंगे तो वो रॉन्ग मैसेज आएगा।
कांग्रेस का एक कॉकस इंडिया गठबंधन के नेतृत्व को हड़पना चाहता था। 19 दिसंबर को अशोका होटल में जो बैठक हुई थी उसमें एक साजिश के तहत इंडिया गठबंधन का नेतृत्व करने के लिए श्री खड़के का नाम सुझाया गया था। इससे पहले मुंबई की बैठक में सर्वसम्मति से तय हुआ था कि बगैर किसी का चेहरा आगे रखे बगैर ये इंडिया गठबंधन काम करेगा।
देखिए, नीतीश कुमार ने जो इस्तीफा देने का निर्णय लिया है इसका हम स्वागत करते हैं। मुझे पहले से मालूम था कि यह अननेचुरल अलायंस है आरजेडी जेडीयू का, बहुत दिनों तक चलेगा नहीं। आज मुझे खुशी है कि नीतीश कुमार ने मुख्यमंत्री पद से इस्तीफा दे दिया और बीजेपी जेडीयू मिलकर बिहार में सरकार बनाएगी, और भारतीय जनता पार्टी के प्रदेश अध्यक्ष श्री सम्राट चौधरी को विधायक दल का नेता और श्री विजय सिन्हा जी को उप नेता चुने जाने पर मैं अपनी ओर से हार्दिक बधाई देता हूँ, और मैं उम्मीद करता हूँ कि अगले 2-3 घंटे के अंदर नई सरकार का गठन हो जाएगा।
जब उसका प्रमुख सूत्रधार ये बोल रहा है तो कोई भविष्य था उसका क्या? कोई वैकेंसी नहीं है प्रधानमंत्री के पद की। भाजपा एनडीए की ऐतिहासिक विजय होगी लोकसभा में, और बिहार में 40 की 40। धन्यवाद।
Governor's residence in Patna have put out this image of Nitish Kumar taking claim to form the government. Samrat Chaudhary can be seen. He is the head of the BJP legislature party. Jitan Ram Manjhi is present as well. Vinod Tavade, the head of the election in charge of Bihar, and also BJP National General Secretary of Bihar, Vijay Chaudhary, who was the finance minister in Nitish Kumar's previous cabinet, will be sworn in as well. So these are the new leaders who went with Nitish for staking claim to form the government. Jitan Ram Manjhi, former Bihar Chief Minister, President of Hindustani Awaz Morcha, which has in all four MLAs in Bihar Assembly. He will be part of the government as well. So Nitish Kumar is taking claim to form the government. Let me go back to the guest. Sumitra Goenka continues to be with us. We also have Anurag. Anurag, coming to you first. This was waiting to happen. It was more. The timing has been chosen by Nitish Kumar and the BJP.
Maria, we are calling, we are inviting, considering numerous others as a political expert. But in my opinion, Nitish Kumar is the greatest and most efficient political pandit, or you can say Chunavi pandit of this time. He can sense where power is shifting. Now he can sense very well that India alliance is not going to make any big impact in 2024 Lok Sabha election, and Bihar as well. As far as Bihar is concerned, as per previous agreement with the Mahagadbandhan with Laluji, he was supposed to give power to Tejaswi Yadav. So his political future as a chief minister was very dim. And as far as national politics is concerned, India bloc is not going to, even they are in very primary stage and the election dates are already announced. So when we have hardly 2-3 months left and India bloc is not going to anywhere, no party is cooperating with the Congress party is not behaving as an elder brother who wants to make a difference. They are not ready to share seats with the regional parties. So in fate of India alliance is not very good as of now. So Nitish Kumar as a very sharp political...
Is there an India alliance? My question is, let's not talk about just fate, but today onwards, is there an India group? Because the architect of that group has left.
No. Yes, you are right, Maria. This time point of time, there is no India alliance. There is no India alliance, and Mr. Nitish Kumar has said this much before us. So he has changed his side, which he is known for also changing side, and people call him Aya Ram, Gaya Ram, and numerous other things. But Nitish Kumar has changed his side for his own future. Because look, if you look of his party's performance in last 15 years, his party's seat share in Bihar Assembly is continuously decreasing. That is a bigger relief for BJP also, because they know that in due course, JDU is going to finish, or you can say is going to become irrelevant. So they have also, they don't have any problem in making alliance with Janata Dal United. That is the biggest point.
And one may say, Anurag, one may say as well that Nitish Kumar has been most comfortable with the BJP. He has been largely a misfit on the other side, because in his 20 years of government, he has spent good 17 years with the BJP. So in all those years, he has worked and functioned rather smoothly with them. So all these temporary experiments that he did with Mahagadbandhan, he just wasn't one may say that it was his ambitions that perhaps drove him towards the other side in 2022. And then he realized that it will not be realized. The ambition will not be realized. He wasn't going to be the convener of India, despite being an architect. So it also speaks about opportunism. It also is a sad reality of politics, Sumitra. It's a sad reality of politics.
Yeah, Maria, whenever somebody, on a personal note, I would say that whenever somebody comes into politics, I think they come in not just only for the social good, but also they have some aspirations in mind. And we have seen that parties which were there in Indie Alliance, everybody wanted to become the prime ministerial candidate or the convener of the party. And somewhere Nitish Kumar has had these aspirations and he had formed this Indie Alliance. He was one of the front runners who had called the first Indie Alliance meeting and chief architect of the Indie Alliance also, some may say. But ultimately, I think he was not able to fulfill those aspirations. And secondly, this alliance never took shape because we have seen everywhere, like right from Punjab to Delhi to West Bengal to other areas, you know, Bihar as well as down south, even Kerala. Everybody had, you know, their own aspirations in mind. Nobody was able to arrive at a decision as to how many seats they would share or how many seats will they give it to Congress or any other party. And I believe alliance was never in place. They were only talking that they are in an alliance, but they were never in an alliance because nothing was decided. There was no agenda. There was no policy in place. And they did not know what to do. They just wanted to come together and find a solution about, you know, how they could face probably Narendra Modi and win the election. And to some extent, I believe they were there to protect their own dynasties. That was the main thing which we were seeing during the Indie Alliance. And unfortunately, these things did not come up for them. So Nitish Kumar is a very shrewd politician, and somewhere probably he was not comfortable there after even initiating this alliance. And then he decided to quickly move out. And like you rightly said, he has been 17 years ally of the NDA, and he has run governments with them as well in a very good way. Bihar had seen a lot of development during that time. And today's politics is such where there is a wave flowing for the BJP. We know for sure that there is no other force for the general elections, which is even near to what the BJP wave is. So it doesn't require any, you know, analysis or anything. You can see on the road, like, because there is no alternate. Congress is almost gone. None of the alliance partners are supporting Congress, or even, you know, within Congress also there are issues. Like, I'm not sure whether Sonia Gandhi is happy that Mallikarjun Kharge is being said to be the head of the alliance by some parties. Well, like, we saw how Nitish Kumar's
India
party
unravels,
said that.
One thing is becoming clear, that NDA is becoming stronger. Sumitra and yes. Anurag, thank you so much for joining us.